Right now, many of us humans are thinking. But we may not realize that this process affects our reality. Yes, every time you think, every visualization you create in your mind, they leave your mind in the form of light waves. We know this because by attaching electrodes to the human head, we can receive those light waves and connect them to a computer to analyze the brain. Yes, when you think about something, that information leaves your mind and goes to spacetime in the form of light waves. But believe it or not, others can create quantum entanglement with those light waves and download the information you were thinking about. And on the contrary, not only others, but also those around you can put thoughts in your mind through the frequency waves. We all know that humans have six senses. These are sense of sight, sound, taste, touch, smell and. In fact, humans have at least six senses, and a new study suggests that the last sense, proprioception, may have a genetic basis. We use all these senses to engage the world around us. Proprioception is the visual ability to perceive the three-dimensional world, or in other words, how your brain knows where your body is in space. When the police ask a drunk person to touch the tip of their nose with their finger, they are actually testing proprioception. And the point here is that this sense has an important difference from other senses. We know that our world is made up of vibrations and frequencies that are defined for us by neural signals once they reach us. For example, the sense of smell. Do you know what smell is and how you feel it? For example, the smell of a food. You undoubtedly know that the food we eat is made up of various biological molecules that give us energy. And you know that molecules are made up of atoms and subatoms. Now, simply put, the vibrations and frequencies of the food molecule cause the nose receptor electrons to tunnel between energy states, and then nerve signals are sent to the brain. Different vibrational frequencies are detected by different receptors, so because these frequencies are different, we perceive smells differently. And in the same way, our brain analyses the world around us with the help of our other senses that receive different frequencies and vibrations, and send them to the brain. In fact, our five senses are limited and understand only a part of what we call a reality. For example, the human ear can perceive frequencies between 20 Hz and 20,000 Hz. But if we can perceive frequencies outside this range, we can hear the vibration of the planet Earth as it rotates. Or the sound produced by the vibration of the atomic particles that make up our bodies. And you can even go further and hear sounds from other dimensions. In general, it can be said that sound lines are vibration paths that exist in parallel dimensions only with a different frequency. In fact, the human eye can perceive a frequency between 30 and 60 Hz per second. Therefore, the higher the frequency, or in other words, the faster the speed of the frames, the object is out of sight. Consider the blades of a mill. When it starts to spin, you can see it spin and hear its sound. But the higher the speed of spin, the higher the frequency of the sound. But its speed will be slower to your eyes until you see it completely like a fixed white circle, and in the same way, its sound will change to a roaring sound as the frequency increases. Then you will hear the sound of each musical note, and when the frequency reaches 20,000 Hz, you will hear the sound of noise, until the sound goes out of the frequency range of human hearing and you no longer hear a sound. But the higher speed makes the human eyes see this mill in dark red color, then orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, and finally purple. But if the speed continues to increase, you see that the mill starts to melt and fade away. Where do you think the blades of the mill are now? This is called a parallel world. Something that exists but is not at a frequency that your senses perceive. This is all you need to understand so that you can reach the highest state of consciousness and remove all limitations. Although Tibetan natives use waves to navigate in vast lands, but the Tibetan temples teach the nuns some mystical secrets and their relationship with creation. In the temples, there are patterns called mandala on the wall, which is an ancient science. In fact, these mandalas are the main key to communication with other worlds. All the nuns do is start making a certain sound. And this voice is nothing but the same patterns on the wall. Are you confused? The fact is that sound frequencies in different waves begin to produce some kind of pattern. For example, the frequency of 1033 Hz forms this pattern. And the frequency of this one is 1820 Hz. Now, if you change the frequencies rapidly, these patterns will change rapidly. So if you see this pattern somewhere, you will realize that it refers to the sound of 3835 Hz. Now think that these patterns have a special meaning, just like the letters of the alphabet. Many of those who are on the spiritual path sometimes have the experience of hearing voices that are incomprehensible to them. Why is it incomprehensible? Because they don't know the relationship between frequencies and patterns. Generally, what we perceive is an approximate reality, a simplified version by our brain of what surrounds us. Now that you understand how we perceive the world around us, you should also know that you can be controlled through these vibrations and frequencies, and of course your senses that receive these frequencies. Pay attention to this sentence that is found in the Bible, John chapter 1, "In the beginning was the Word. The Word was with God, and the Word was God." Undoubtedly, most of you do not have a clear understanding of this sentence. And of course, if you look for its interpretation by the elders, you will come across this. It teaches us that God is the great originator of all that we know. As the creator of the universe, God was there in the beginning and made a way for us. So that's right. But don't you think John didn't need to speak in code to say that? And this is while John the Apostle was the closest person to Christ. The one who, unlike others, did not leave him alone until the last moment. He who was poisoned by the Roman emperor to kill but did not die. The only person after Christ who possessed the ancient knowledge or the Holy Grail, and who, as we explained in the Sons of Mithras article, most of his writings were banned. Although this statement is not difficult to understand, but let's open this code. He is literally referring to a world that is not physical. He refers to the true self of man. Pure energy that has been forced to experience the physical world. Here he says that in the beginning there was vibration and frequency, which is energy. Energy was with God and energy was God. Did you ask how? Well, it's very simple. Words are energy. Words can make or break. Words can motivate or discourage. Words influence others and build relationships. They can even destroy relationships. Because the power in words comes from absolute coherence, alignment, and integration between what we think, say, and do. Therefore, with the words we speak, we influence that area and that process of manifestation. But there are certain words, powerful words, or divine words, which are often kept very secret. And they are usually used in ceremonies where we have no way to go. Yes, words are the same frequencies that your sense of hearing receives and then sends to the brain through nerve signals.
You cannot. You cannot. You cannot.
And if you remember the video of opening the third eye, you saw that we said that whatever you deeply think about, or your mind is engaged in, will make your tomorrow. Now these signals can be sent to your brain through television, radio, even advertising. Do you know what this word means? Thank you for reading. I didn't even need to use audio frequency here. Because you read my message into your brain through the sense of sight that receives electromagnetic frequencies. Although you did this consciously, these messages can be sent to your brain unconsciously. For example, a specific word or photo that is deliberately placed in your path many times throughout the day. In one of the episodes of The Late Late Show, hosted by James Corden, a mentalist named Lior Suchard forced the entire audience, more than 200 people, to draw a five-pointed star on a white paper. But what does this teach us? This teaches us that those who are familiar with real science use it to control others, so it is to their advantage that you remain in deep sleep. But frequencies can also be found in music. While ancient people recognized that these sounds could have profound effects even on objects, modern research is just beginning to explore the possibilities. For example, studies have shown that the frequency of 432 Hz is mathematically consistent with the universe. And this means that humans can connect to this frequency. Even this frequency affects your subconscious mind, and you will feel better unintentionally. According to a study, when someone listens to 432 Hz music, their heart rate slows down and blood pressure reaches the most normal possible state. The greatest musicians such as Mozart or Chopin based their music on the natural vibration of 432 Hz. According to Richard Huiskin, music tuned to 432 Hz works on the heart chakra and also has a great effect on the spiritual development of listeners. Researchers claim that you will feel more relaxed and happy when playing or listening to 432 Hz frequency. Of course, the solfege frequency of 432 Hz is not the only one that is important. Let's look at the result of an experiment published on the official website of the National Center for Biotechnology Information Library. Sound waves with a frequency of 528 Hz can induce the production of testosterone in the brain. It reduces the total concentration of active oxidative species in the brain tissue. And we know that the induction of testosterone production means reducing anxiety. In the end, it says that this study may lead to the identification of a possible treatment in which sounds are used to reduce anxiety in people. But in 1885, the Italian government's music commission declared that all instruments in Italy must be tuned with a tuning fork at 440 Hz, as opposed to the 432 Hz standard used by arch-rival France. Then in 1917, the American Federation of Musicians supported the Italians and tuned the instruments to 440 Hz. And finally in 1953, a universal agreement was signed. And that's why the sound of the piano in the United States is exactly like the sound of the piano in China. But according to researchers, perhaps the best known of whom is renowned musician and researcher Brian T. Collins, 440 Hz is not at any level consistent with cosmic motion, rhythm, or natural vibration. Well, it's true that only 8 vibrations per second is different from the standard setting, but it seems like a very significant number for human consciousness. And this made many consider the frequency of 440 Hz to be evil. But the fact is that the pure frequency itself is not the slightest problem. And as I said, the main problem is that humans were deprived of receiving the 432 frequency. Brian Pi says 432 Hz vibrates on the principles of Pi and golden ratio, unifying the properties of light, time, space, matter, gravity, and magnetism with our biology, DNA code, and our higher consciousness. The natural tuning of 432 Hz has profound effects on our consciousness, as well as on the cellular level of our bodies. Let's listen to a 432 Hz music for 30 seconds. By retuning your musical instruments and using a concert tune at 432 Hz, instead of 440 Hz, your atoms and DNA begin to resonate in harmony with nature's Pi spiral. Now that you are more familiar with the importance of vibration and frequency, try to always have positive thoughts and vibrate in the frequencies of love and affection. Consider two tuning forks. Both vibrate at 440 Hz. When one begins to vibrate, the other begins to vibrate. This is not magic, this is the law of attraction. If you understand that, you can turn your world into a paradise. This means that positive emotions with a certain frequency can attract positive events in our lives. Yes, if you think you can, or if you think you can't, you are right in both cases. As I said, different frequencies have different effects on your brain. For example, music tuned to 396 Hz helps to eliminate fears, worries, unconscious anxieties, guilt, and negative unconscious beliefs that block the path to achieving personal goals. Or if you are trying to calm your mind and strengthen your intuitive powers, play 852 Hz music in a quiet volume while meditating. So now let's use this science and refresh ourselves. We have prepared different musics with different frequencies that you can read about their importance on our website, and also listen to the music. The link is in the description.